a bull, kangaroo, sticks his face in, shoves it down. Brett and I were like, are you seeing this shit? Fuck! Everybody else in the bar is like, you know, big deal. Not that it happens every day. This stuff, you know, we see it all the time, so we really don't care. There's the two Americans over there, they think they're seeing something. We're like, yeah, right. We're like, but, look at this. So no one really cared, except us. So we asked the bartender, what's the deal? Bartender says, okay, here's what's going on. This kangaroo had been, his family had been killed by poachers. And this farmer finds him as a baby, takes the little worm home, raises him. Every day he'd come in, have a beer on the way home. So the kangaroo guy used to drink a beer here every day. The farmer dies, the kangaroo still comes. So I give him his beer, because I'm not going to argue with him. And I feed him, and he goes wherever he goes. He comes back the next day. So we're like, really? And no one really, like, pays attention to this. Yeah, it's been going on for 20 years. No one really cares. You know, tell somebody, yeah, laugh at you. So we go back to the hotel, and we tell us the guys in the band, dude, you guys got to see this. They're like, right. Sure you did. Uh-huh. And how much acid do you guys get? What are you guys doing with your time off? You know, something's not right here. They go the next day and they come back. Did you see that kangaroo? And yeah, we saw it. How much acid did you guys get? But it's true, and it was there. And so I told this story to my drum mechanic and our sound guy, Darren Drew, and he writes a song about it. I'd like to do it for you. Now, here you go.
to the bowl and drinking the beer to the bottle. Do you believe it or do you not? We hope you do, but just remember, these are trained professionals. Don't try this at home. So we're going to take it back home. Mr. Ellie Hayes will bring it on from there. Thank you very much.